Hey folks, Mel the Train Tutor back in the studio and back with my Burma Build. Yes, it's been a little while, my hobby project is back and we're cracking on with it. Now, if you're not aware what the Burma Build is, it's my own personal jungle terrain build for my Warlord Bolt Action Chindit Army. It's been a project that's been going on for years and we keep dipping back into it. So I've got it on the desk and I'm carrying on. Now, in the last episode, I was working with palm trees and I was doing some stuff with basing. So what I was doing is, I was working with putting these palm trees together. And I started doing my herb basing. And then I suddenly realised, I hadn't actually worked out what I want the paths in my jungle to look like. So, work got halted. And I got stuck into this. Okay, now this is a 2 foot by 4 foot herb board. It hasn't been painted yet. That's one of my jobs tonight. So I'm going to throw some paint on this tonight. And then once that's dry, what I can start to do is start messing with different colours. And I can simply come along and try different paths to figure out what colours I want to use as my jungle set. Because this is going to be a large build. It's going to go on for a long time. So I want to make sure I pick the right colours at the start. Because I can't really change things as I go on. Well, not without great difficulty anyway. So, palm tree wise, I've put all these together. Okay, and these are to be added to some more bases. Now, when I put my terrain together, one of the things I noticed is I've done a lot of round bases, scatter bases for my jungle terrain. And what this means is when I place them down on the table, there's gaps in between them, quite large gaps. So I came up with this idea of inverse basing, or as Tam says, concave basing, which are these. Okay, and the idea is that these are able to sit sort of in between your scatter bases, yeah, and fill the gaps. So one of the jobs, I didn't do much on these because I wanted to finish the palm tree. So one of my jobs is, I want to glue some whatchacallit palm trees onto those, start those doing, filler up the bases, and then get them ready for putting some herbs and some paint on and that sort of stuff once we've figured out the paths. So, next job, paint this up brown, mount some palm trees. Yeah. I think that'll do us. Right, cracking on time. So the jobs are progressing nicely. Let me show you where I'm up to. Okay, my palm trees, as you can see, I've got these based, yeah, glued down with hot glue, put over with some filler, yeah, and they're working rather nice. Okay, now I need to put these to the side for 1 second because I've got some more sort of hot gluing and sort of fixing on to do. Now, I got a little bit confused because I had a lot more bases than I had palm trees. Which is a rarity for me. Yeah, and I was trying to figure out, okay, what am I missing here? Then I remembered I cut these additional bases, okay, to use with these pieces, okay? Now, these aren't my palm tree pieces, okay? These are my, my open sort of movable through cover sort of. If you look, they've got paths in. Okay, and the idea was that I made up a load of these. Okay, now these are just simple oval bases, yeah, with just a couple of plastic plants on. And the idea was they'd sit between pieces and basically fill up the jungle a bit, much like this, my idea of this converse, inverse basing. Concave, converse, not concave, concave, yeah. But anyway, much like that idea. And they didn't really work because they kept getting knocked over by my hands. So what I thought was, I've got these, I've got a ton of these, why not get these and then just simply start gluing these on and then blend them in and make larger pieces that I can drop in. So my next task is I need to get a load of these. I need to glue them to a load of these. I then need to blend it in with filler. So we're getting to the stage where at the same stage as the palm trees. And then after that, we'll paint them up, add the herbs and stuff. Now, I don't mind that taking a little time, because at the same time, we've got this to work on. Yeah, now that's pretty much how it's dried right now. Okay, try it on that camera. Both my cameras are lined for close-up, so you can't see it, guys. Here you are. In fact, there you are. That's one shot you can see. So that's where I am right now. My next job with regards to the board and preparing these pieces is I need to have a play with this and figure out how I'm going to do my pass. So, cracking on time. So I've reached a point where all my bases are herbed up and they're looking rather nice. Okay, they're a bit bare at the minute because I haven't put any more foliage on. Now at the start of this video, one of the things that I wanted to work out was that idea of how the hell am I going to do pass through this jungle? Okay, because I wasn't really sure on how I was going to lighten it up so I'd have the dark features on the edge, on the foliage and that sort of stuff, and then light pass through it. And you see, I've been racking my brains for ages, you know, we've done this board. Yeah, I've even been playing around on the other side of it with different colours and mixing different colours into my browns and that sort of stuff. And none of it was coming together until, yeah, we herbed up some of the inverse bases. Now these started off as those little bits, those little scatter bases that I glued down. And then as part of sort of blending in, obviously these had the foliage on first, and then I've come in and added my herbs. Then I've added my brown wash to stain the herbs down. And the transitions between them are really, really nice. Okay, so much so that I've actually started to think that actually, do I really want to lighten up the pass or should I darken them down a bit and actually add a bit more of the wash in to make it a more muddy path? And I think that's the way I'm going to go, yeah? This is one of the problems with long-term projects. I mean, I started this years ago and I dip into it every so often and my techniques have improved, the way I think has changed, the way I do modelling has changed. And so quite often you're left with something you started with, an idea a while ago, and you're stepping it up and changing it. And that's what I've got to do with these. So with that in mind, yeah, the transition on that. Now, these are my old pieces, the first ones I did. And as you can see, the transition line between the green and the brown there is pretty harsh. But if I mix up a watered down mix of my brown and perhaps go in with an airbrush and just do it on the transfer line, I should get blending like these, which will be perfect. So, I think I now have a way of doing my paths on all my old stuff. Now that's gonna require some effort on all that old stuff to go around and touch that up. So I'll do that in a separate video to bring them up. What I've gotta do with these is finish them off. Now, as far as I'm concerned, yeah, I'm pretty happy with how the smaller scatter bases are looking, to be perfectly honest. They're looking rather nice and, other than a few touch-ups, maybe a bit of sealing and some washes on the plastic plants, I think, to be perfectly honest, I'm done with these for now. Okay, now that just leaves me with my palm trees, okay, which are looking, as you can see, a bit bare. Yeah, they look great and they work great and the ground's great, but it's just palm trees and grounds. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to get a bit of my Burma mix, a bit of clump foliage, that sort of stuff, a bit of the sort of stuff I've been using on these. Add a little bit into my palm trees just to bulk them up and to sort of give them a bit of variation. Once that's done, they should be pretty much sorted. And we're getting there. So, I'm going to go get all my usual flock and foliages out, and then I'm going to crack on. Yeah, and we'll get these up to speed, shall we say. Right, cracking on time. So I've got my palm tree bases clumped up and they're looking rather beautiful. Yeah, take a look at that. There you go. Now, once again, yeah, we've got this harsh transition. I mean, these are all well stuck on. I've sealed these on with a bit of watered down PVA and a bit of flow aid. Yeah, and they're all fine. But we still got our stark transition, yeah, from the green to the brown. Yeah, and I'm on this jolly to sort of figure out these paths. Now, if I pull and I put it on here, looks rather good, doesn't it? I've matched that damn good. You can see the dark line just underneath it. The reason being is this has actually got a texture on it, obviously. So it's not actually sitting flat. When I actually do this, what I'll do is I'll actually put my herbs flat. I'll roll them flat so I won't get that dark line underneath. Okay, but it's looking rather good. Most definitely. Yeah, now my next step is I need to blend these transitions into here. And this is a bit of a crucial one for me, to be perfectly honest. Yeah, I've been avoiding this because I don't know how it's going to turn out. Right. In for a penny, in for a pound, isn't it? You've got to give it a go. I can't just leave them like this. So what I've done is I've mixed up some of my base brown with a bit of water to make a wash. I've got my airbrush and I'm going to use my airbrush to apply it. Normally I'd just use a brush, but a brush can go in a bit too heavy. And because I don't know how this is going to turn out, I'm not really sure if I want to go in too heavy. Therefore, if I use an airbrush, I've got a little bit more control over it while I figure it out. Now, what might happen is I might start with the airbrush and think, do you know what, I can whack this on with a brush. All well and good. But what I don't want to do is whack it on with a brush, end up with harsh lines where, you know, I've got more concentration of the brown and then I've got the sort of the faded effects. I'm hoping the airbrush will let me feather that a bit better. Don't know. Right. Next time I talk to you, I'm either going to be a happy chappy or an unhappy chappy. I don't know which, but I can't procrastinate anymore. I've got to get it done. I've got to move on with this. Otherwise, it's going to become a stopping block. And I'm getting ready to make the board and that sort of stuff. So I've got to get it sorted. So with that in mind, let me get set up. Right, I'll take that as a win. Very quickly, just to show you before I crack on. Happy mail. Yeah, take a look at that. Look at the difference, yeah? Now, all I've done is just gone in with that little watered down brown and just gone round those edges. Just a little, just to add that brown in. But if you notice, what it's done is across the whole brown piece, it's knocked it back a little and it looks so much more realistic. It looks so much nicer. Secondly, those harsh transition lines, they blended out. I mean, you can see clearly on here where the green stops and the brown starts. Whereas on this one, yeah. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, yeah. 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 I might even go in and do a little bit more with it in the future, yeah, and touch up a bit more. I know I'm going to be coming back and doing a bit more on these anyway, but holy Hannah, I am happy. So, with that in mind, yeah, I'm going to do the rest of these. And we'll see how they turn out, eh? Cracking on time. So that turned out far better than I could have ever expected. And it's had a sort of an unexpected sort of bonus. Let me bring these across. Right. So as you can see, yeah, I've got all my lovely browns on there now. And the blend between the green and the brown is so much better. But also by putting a wash, by a little bit of the overspray with the airbrush. And I couldn't have done this with a brush method. Yeah. It's knocked all the green back and it's added the brown into the green, which has just joined them together and it makes them look like they belong. Now, so let me show you what I mean. Yeah, if I bring in one of these pieces, which is one of my earlier scatter pieces, yeah, look at the difference in the greenery. Yeah, just by putting a bit of a spray in. Obviously the blend's better, but also this is really bright. Yeah, compared to this has been knocked back and I really like this, especially for the ground stuff. So what I'm curious about is, yeah, shall we give this a go and see how these come out? So I'll give it a go on this test piece. Well, it's not a test piece, but you know what I mean. Yeah, we'll see how it comes out. So if we come in here, yes. Oh God, yes. Oh God. Mel's a happy man. Look at it already. Yeah, I can see it. I'm not sure if you can, but it is knocking it back. It is blending it in really nicely. Yeah, really nicely. So I think the battle plan now is I'm gonna have to do all these, aren't I? Hey ho, in for a penny, in for a pound. Let's get cracked on. So that's all my airbrushing done, and I got a bit carried away, as you can see. Basically, in front of me, what I've got is I've got all my dense cover in bolt action terms. Dense cover is line of sight blocking to a certain extent, but troops can move through it. So basically, thick jungle, but not line of sight or movement blocking, like my stuff down there. And basically, I started off with palm trees, then I started doing those pieces. Then I started doing my inverse bases, then I thought, sod it, let's do the lot. Yeah, and I did all my smaller scatter pieces as well. I've still got to do all my major jungle. I'm going to leave that to a separate video because I want to update those with a few extra plants and stuff like that as well. It's been a while since I've done any work on those and things have improved on that side as well, so I want to revisit it. Okay, but to show you the difference it makes, yeah, you can see all these here. Yeah, they started off with those sort of colours on them. Harsh transition lines. Yeah, really vibrant greens and that sort of stuff. The brown has worked beautifully. Yeah, for just blending them all together and that sort of stuff. But there is one proof of the pudding. Okay, now what I've got over just over here, yeah, is I've got my board. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move all these to one side. I'm going to get my board out. We're going to lay these on and we're going to see what it looks like with a 2 foot square of jungle. Yeah, I might have a bit too much for a 2 foot square of jungle, but we'll get to check it out nonetheless. So, yeah, let's get cracked on. And there we have it. Doesn't she look beautiful? Look how the colours all blend together. It's near perfect. Right, okay, this is a video. I'm getting dewy-eyed here. I'll be honest with you guys. It's been a long time since I've had one of those moments in the studio where trying something new immediately goes ping, and the results you get from going on and transitioning across that, across your entire project, beautiful. My Burma board is coming together, guys. It really is. Right, as you can see, yeah, it all works. The colours look great. It blends together. My inverse basing is working great. It's fitting in the gaps. My little scatter bases, I can't even see them, these ones. Yeah, they're dropping in really nice. Yeah, inverse bases. Look how clever that works. Perfect. Oh, can I play on a board that dense? That'd be crazy. Right then, guys. I'm a bit lost, to be truthful. Okay then. Right, brain, engage the brain vertical. Right. All that my sort of dense scatter terrain pieces have now been done, as much as I want to do them. I've still got my full terrain scatter that I want to do, yeah, but there's some other bits I want to build and I might add to them. So I'm not sure about the next video whether we'll do the same on the next video or whether I'll expand that set. And I'll explain why, what you've got in the next video. But whether we expand that set and, you know, then weather it, or whether we just weather it and leave the expansion, I don't know. Either way, I am made up with this lot, and I've got loads more there. Happy chappy, yeah? It's all coming together and it's looking beautiful. So the Big Burma Build is back. I may be looking for someone on YouTube to do a battle rep with. I'll bring my own table, yeah? So if you've got any recommendations, let me know in the comments. And if you've got any questions or anything like that, I know it's my personal project, but I'm here to help, guys. So down in the comments, leave me your questions. I'll do my best to help you. Like it, share it, as always. And as always, if you really do enjoy these videos and you want to keep them coming, remember there's links down below to the Patreon, the PayPal and the Amazon wish list, so you can pledge a dollar, donate a one-off, or if you're not into the cash thing, buy something useful for the studio. It all helps me in here making these videos, sharing techniques, sharing the ups and downs, and this big smile on my face with you guys. So if you like it, guys, please consider supporting it. And I do rely on you folks who make it to the end of the video for all my support. So, I appreciate it, guys. Right, she's glorious, I'm happy, I'm lost for words, so I'll say goodnight. Goodnight? Oh, I'm all over the place. Listen, I'll see you soon, guys. All the best, yeah? Ta-ra.